Can you tell us about the industry's relationship to the Aboriginal community and how that's changed over time?
Well, as you know, the Canadian minerals industry is the largest employer of Aboriginal people in Canada, and we have more activities in close proximity to Aboriginal communities. In fact, TAC was a leader in its relationship with respect to the communities in and around the Red Dog Mine and the NANA organization. So, I mean, TAC, I think, has shown that it's always been very respectful and taking a leadership. And that, of course, was in particular Cominco initially prior to the merger. You also have the situation, and you can look to Sudbury and Highland Valley, where the Aboriginal community has not necessarily historically been incorporated and engaged in the operations as much as would happen now. But those things are changing. I know for a fact that the TAC has reaching out around all its coal operations and Highland Valley in particular, to the Indigenous community at Hemlo. We worked with Pick River and the Pick Mobert First Nations, looking at ensuring that there are benefits flowing to the community and negotiating participation agreements. So it's really, really changed. And with the change in the regulatory framework, the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous People, the focus on free, prior, and informed consent, companies realize now that until you have the support and the willingness of the community to welcome you onto their land and to develop the resources in partnership, it's not going to happen. And I would say TAC was a leader in this, particularly because of their experience at Red Dog in the early days before this topic even was on the minds of many.